What's going on, everyone? My name is Ovi and welcome to a new FIFA 21 tutorial on the channel. In the next couple of minutes, I'm gonna present you three new simple settings that will help you improve your game. Before getting started, make sure to smash the like button if you love the tutorial series on the channel, if you cannot wait for the next video with tips and tricks from FIFA 21. First on my list, we've got the contextual agile dribbling setting from controller settings. This option should always be on off. Now, of course, you're gonna ask, Ovi, why do we need to have this on off? Well, boys, if you have it on, in certain scenarios, your player, in certain moments, he will do automatically agile dribbling. If you don't know what agile dribbling is, it is a new feature from FIFA 21. Actually, a very, very nice feature in which you get the chance to use the dribbling abilities of your player. The more agile your player is, the better at dribbling the stats that your player has are, then you will be able to do some fantastic moves using agile dribbling. I've got a tutorial about it. Just check the channel out and you will see over there how good this is. But you want to do agile dribbling when you trigger that motion. You do not want this motion to be triggered automatically in some moments by the AI. In certain scenarios, it might prove to be effective to have the help from the AI by doing the automatic agile dribbling. But in some moments, you will lose the ball because your player will start doing agile dribbling even though you didn't want that. Sometimes you'll be surprised by this. You do want to have full control over your player. You do not want to have the AI helping you in this matter. You want to do the agile dribbling when you choose to do it, not when the AI chooses it. Because trust me, in a lot of moments, if you have contextual agile dribbling on, in a lot of moments the AI will make mistakes and that will not help you. You will lose possession of the ball. Imagine doing agile dribbling with a player, I don't know, like Casemiro or another player that has nothing to do with dribbling in FIFA 21. That's a no-go. So remember, boys, super, super important, contextual agile dribbling, the setting must be always, always off. This way you get to tell always to your player what to do and when to do it. Also, imagine that you are just walking with your player, you want to do a skill move when you reach the opponent, and boom, in the second that you want to do a skill move, your player does the contextual agile dribbling. So remember, always, always have it on off. Next on the list, we've got competitor mode on off. And let me tell you a little story about this and how I found out that this is a great, great, great option that needs to stay on off. I was playing squad battles, I actually finished squad battles in the first weekend. I won all the games, 40 games on Legendary and Ultimate. I heard on Twitter that it is just almost impossible, especially with an RTG squad. So playing squad battles, Legendary, RTG squad, won all my games. It was actually quite easy to be honest. I found some mechanics that I was able to, that helped me to open the defense. But what I want to tell you here is, I got 21st in the world with an RTG squad, and afterwards I see on Twitter this option. They were talking about competitor mode and why it should be on off. I hadn't even checked it out. And then I went to FIFA, I saw what competitor mode is, and it makes sense. Let me read it to you. So, enable this setting to face a more challenging opponent that simulates the playstyle of some of world's best FIFA players. The setting can only be enabled on Legendary or Ultimate difficulty. So imagine, I was playing Legendary with competitor mode on, and I was facing, according to FIFA 21, a more challenging opponent because competitor mode was on. Okay, I understand that some of you may also want to try this on, but why try it in squad battles? And squad battles at the beginning of the game is super important to gather coins, and you can get better scores, better results with competitor mode being off. So make sure to use this option on off. If you wanna, I don't know, if you wanna have a career mode, play a career mode, and you've mastered ultimate difficulty, please be my guest. Put competitive mode on. But if you're playing on legendary, on ultimate, and you're having super big problems in squad battles, or when playing a career mode, then you gotta go here, check it off, and then it will be slightly easier for you to win the games. Again, I'm not necessarily a big fan of playing legendary and feeling it like professional. But when you play squad battles, and everyone in the world maybe is putting this competitor mode off and getting better results than you, be my guest, please do it, put it off. Use this advantage, get the better results in squad battles, get the better rewards, get the better players for your ultimate team. Super important option here. Last but not least, we've got the new team press system. In previous years, EA Sports has added in the game this team press option for the fast tactics in the game. This season, this is extremely, extremely effective. You will be able to win against better players only by using this tactic, but you gotta be careful with it because it has a timer. A timer means that you cannot go from minute 1 to minute 90 using team press. No. You will have around 60 seconds of using this option in the game. 60 seconds, I didn't count it. You can see the timer there. You can see the green timer going down and showing you how much you've got left at team press. Again, I'm not saying that you should be starting with this tactic from minute 1. But I'm telling you that it is an extremely overpowered tactic now, at this moment with the current meta. The new pressing system, it is just insane. If you don't know how to trigger it, you just use the D-pad, boys. You press down and from there on, you just check the team press. It's super, super, super easy. Also, time it properly. Read the game. For example, maybe you want to start strong again. First 10 minutes, push high. Push your opponent, score fast, and then take team press off. Very important how you time everything. Or when your opponent scores a goal and you want him to feel the pressure immediately afterwards, the new team press system is very, very good for that. And again, I want to emphasize this. Be careful when you use it, because if you abuse it, you might find yourself in a situation when you actually need to team press and you don't have time on the timer. There's nothing left. You've already used it. So make sure to think properly when you are using this tactic. But overall, it is extremely, extremely overpowered this year, and it will help you so much get better results against better players than you. So fellas, these were the three new simple settings that will improve your game. And trust me, they will. The contextual agile dribbling on off, the competitor mode on off for squad battles especially, and the new pressing system. Make sure to check them out, use them as I told you, and you will see the results improving. Until next time, make sure to smash the like button, show your support towards the channel. I'll see you fellas in the next episode. Bye-bye.